have been talking about the different reasons why the teeth can become shaky. Otherwise, your tooth has to be there, or the teeth has to stay there until you have hunger or until you want food to be eaten. That means until you die. So you need to keep your teeth like that or strong until you die. What are the treatments for shaky teeth? This is what we will be covering on this day's episode. Please make sure that you subscribe, and also make sure that you send this video to those people whom you know that are older and also would like to keep their teeth until they die.
Time won't wait for you. Technology can't be redefined. We are ready to start the game. DQ Watches, your style icon.
I am Dr. Thomas Nichipadam. I am from Nichipadam Dental in Kerala. I have been treating patients with shaky teeth for past 20 years. With all these experience, I'll tell you, none of the teeth has to be extracted unless it is very shaky and it comes off when you pull it with your tooth, with your hand itself. If it is not been able to be pulled out by your hand, most of the teeth can be saved. So if you cannot remove the tooth and if it is still shaky, make sure that you go to your dentist, try to save the tooth itself. If it is already been really bad and if it has been pulled out, please make sure that you replace the tooth so that the opposing teeth, just like what I told you in the last video, please make sure that you replace that tooth immediately so that you will not lose the opposing tooth. So what is the treatment for shaky tooth? The easiest way or the conventional way of doing it was a splinting. What is a splinting? Splinting is a method by which you attach the tooth to the next teeth using a wire or a crown or a joint crown or something like that, or even a fiber. Now a glass fibers have come. So glass fiber methods of attaching the tooth to the next and surrounding teeth so that it becomes stronger. Why is splinting important? Because if the teeth has already become shaky, it needs to be healed. It is just like putting a plaster onto your broken hand or a broken leg. You put a plaster so that it becomes once again joined to the bone. Bone becomes joined to the bone if you do a plastering of the same, just like you do a splinting of your broken leg or broken hand and things like that. So this is also one way of doing it. So that is called as a splinting, or we just hold the tooth in the position with the help of the rest of the teeth. But this will not suffice. We will have to remove all what in the previous video I have spoken about different reasons for becoming shaky. We have to remove all the reasons for becoming shaky so that it doesn't become more and more shaky or even doesn't spread to the next tooth. So what all are the reasons for shaking? I've been telling that there is a traumatic occlusion, or there is a tooth which is actually hitting onto this tooth which is shaking in a wrong way. If it is in a wrong way, then what happens is basically we'll have to correct that, or the force on the tooth has to be removed. Or if you have a bad habit like opening bottles, you'll have to stop that. Or if you have calculus or plaque which is accumulated, you'll have to remove it completely. But removing the plaque or calculus which is outside only will not help. What else can be done? We'll have to open up the gums using a flap surgery method, and then we'll have to go deep inside. We'll have to remove the infection which is there, the plaque which is there, the calculus which is there, and maybe if the bone is also gone, we'll have to replace it with bone grafting. The bone grafting is a method by using artificial bone or even human bone, which is actually just like kidney donation. We can actually donate bone and then it has been radiated and it can be used in the area of missing bone, so that the bone will be once again holding onto the tooth and the tooth becomes more stronger. So bone grafting or even bone regeneration techniques. There are different techniques by which we can regrow the bone of your own thing. By some are using plasma, some are using some some of these bone regeneration techniques which are there according to some areas. It cannot be done everywhere, but it can be done in some areas. If at all the whole environment is good, definitely the bone will regrow. Then there is one more reason why the bone would have gone, that is osteoporosis or a vitamin D deficiency. If there is an osteoporosis or a vitamin deficiency, please make sure that the reasons for the osteoporosis has to be stopped. Sometimes in women we'll have to give estrogen supplements, sometimes we'll have to give vitamin D supplements for those people. Sometimes, especially in people who have covered the body fully, or people who doesn't go out, just like the IT people or even people who work only in a closed environment, will have to be exposed to some sunlight or give vitamin D supplements so that they'll get enough supplements in their body and make sure that the bone is formed around the tooth. These are the different treatments. So it is a combination treatment. It's not one treatment or two treatment which is not there. And the most important thing is a follow-up, because all these treatments are done because the tooth has become shaky. There are reasons for it, so we need to do a follow-up so that whether the force is correct, whether your calculus and your plaque formation has been reduced. If it is there, then we'll have to clean up on a regular basis. Sometimes a 4-month appointment is required, sometimes a 6-month appointment is required. Sometimes we'll have to really improve upon your oral hygiene skills. We'll have to supplement it with a water pick, or we'll have to supplement it with a electronic toothbrush if you have some difficulty, especially in brushing and things like that, because of a paralytic arm, or sometimes dexterity or problems with your pain or something like that. So it is very important that we maintain the oral hygiene. Especially if you have a plaque and calculus, you'll have to go and get it cleaned. It is not about the frequency which the doctor says. If you feel that there is a calculus which is there, you'll have to do it. And also, as I told, you can use all these aids like your electronic toothbrush, and you can also use your water sprays like water pick and water floss and things like that can be used, so that you can clean it up and keep it. And if at all you lose any of this tooth, please make sure that you replace it. So just because it is shaky doesn't mean that it is over. So please make sure that you go to a good periodontist and periodontal treatment expert and get it done. Rather, it is much better to keep your own tooth, which is God given, than to replace it. So make sure that you use the tooth, and if at all you lose it, then we can think about artificial methods of keeping back the tooth and how to replace the tooth. But the whole point now is the whole world is turning to replace. Whole world is turning to a place where even if you go to with a car to a service guy, he'll always tell that, okay, oh, door is getting jammed, okay, we'll just change the door and put it. It's not like that. It's your own organ. It's not that you can replace your arm with something else, or you don't replace your eye with something else. So make sure that it is just like an organ in your body. So tooth also is like that. So make sure that you do whatever to save the tooth and use the tooth until it goes off. If at all you cannot save, then make sure that you replace it with an artificial tooth so that the rest of the teeth also is saved. For more of these type of topics, to understand more about dental treatments, what all to be done, how to keep the teeth well, please subscribe, please send it to all your friends so that they also will be benefited from this. Dr. Thomas from Nichipadam Dental.
Build your brand globally. Make your venture a success. Unique Times, Premium Business Lifestyle Magazine.